Omar Vizquel is a former Major League star. He hasn't played in almost a decade, but he sure played a lot when he did. Vizquel, who is from Venezuela, was a shortstop and a pretty darn good one, known as one of the best defensive infield captains ever. He made the All-Star team 3 times, won the Gold Glove Award 11 times, is tied for the highest fielding percentage of all time, is the all-time leader in games played, has turned the most double plays of all time, has more hits than any player from Venezuela until Miguel Cabrera passed him, has the third most hits of all shortstops in history, played 24 seasons of baseball, and played until he was 45 years old. So yeah, Omar Vizquel is a highly regarded and respected when it comes to former baseball players and their legacies. But it's what he's done since retirement that may be tarnishing his legacy. Take a second to like this video, and if you're new to the channel and end up enjoying this video, be sure to hit that subscribe button for future baseball content. Omar Vizquel started his major league career off with the Seattle Mariners in 1989, going on to get traded to the Cleveland Indians after the 1993 season. Vizquel was a part of some really successful Indians teams, as they'd actually make it to the World Series in 1995 and 1997, losing to the Atlanta Braves in 95 and then the Florida Marlins in 97. A year after they lost to the Marlins in 1997, Vizquel made the All-Star team for the first time in his career in 1998. The following year after that in 1999, Vizquel had the best year of his entire 24-year career. He hit .333 with an .833 OPS in 144 games. Vizquel was never that good of a hitter, with his OPS actually being in the 500s or 600s most years. An OPS in the 700s was really solid for Vizquel, so you could probably tell that his .833 OPS in 1999 was beyond great for his standards. The incredible defense is what kept him on major league rosters throughout the years, where he'd go on to make the All-Star team for the third and final time of his career in 2002 before signing with the San Francisco Giants before the 2005 season, where he'd go on to play for 4 years before playing the final 4 years of his career with the Rangers in 2009, the White Sox in 2010 and 2011, and finally the Blue Jays in 2012, going on to be the last position player born in the 1960s, along with the last to play in the 1980s to retire. So the 2012 season ended, and on came retirement, with it not taking very long for Vizquel to find his way back into the game via a coaching job. In January of 2013, the very next year after he retired, Vizquel got a job with the Anaheim Angels to be a co-infield coach. Following the 2013 season, Vizquel moved on to become the Detroit Tigers' first base coach, also serving as the team's infield and base running instructor. Vizquel actually ended up going on to interview for the managerial job after Brad Ausmus was let go, but did not get the position since Ron Gardenhire was hired instead. Vizquel went on to go back to the White Sox organization in 2017, managing their Class A advanced team and getting promoted to manage the White Sox AA affiliate in 2018. And this is where things start to go downhill for Vizquel and his legacy. Vizquel was fired by the White Sox and their AA affiliate after an incident which took place between himself and a male employee, leading to a Major League Baseball investigation. Major League Baseball then had to launch yet another investigation into Vizquel a year later in 2020 after he was accused of domestic assault by his former wife. According to The Athletic's Katie Strong and Ken Rosenthal, his wife went through years of physical abuse before leaving from their home in Arizona and filing for divorce. There were multiple occurrences of Omar hurting his wife, so that alone is a problem. We then now have more info on the incident that happened back in 2019 between Vizquel and a male employee of the White Sox AA team. A longtime bat boy was the male employee of that AA affiliate, as he just recently filed a lawsuit against Vizquel for taking advantage of him. Part of the issue is the fact that this bat boy in particular is autistic, and part of the argument by him and his party is that Vizquel took advantage of the fact that he was autistic to make him do unnecessary and inappropriate things. The lawsuit says that this type of stuff happened at least 5 times, as the 25-year-old bat boy is accusing the White Sox and their AA affiliate of violating the Americans with Disabilities Act and seeks back pay and damages. At the time of this lawsuit being made, Vizquel was no longer a part of any major league organization, as he was the manager of the Tijuana Bulls in the Mexican Baseball League. He has now been fired from that position with the team. Who knows what will end up becoming of all this, but it's pretty clear that Omar Vizquel has a history of being very inappropriate and problematic. From a former Major League Baseball legend, someone who played almost 25 seasons, won a ton of gold gloves, made all-star teams, was an overall really solid defensive player, and a Venezuelan baseball legend, to now someone who has been alleged of assault twice now based of multiple occurrences of it each time, we may be seeing the downfall of someone who had a good legacy. Let me know what you think, and thank you for watching.